that. Yo, bitch, I been getting cash. Cash, bitch, yo, racks on racks on racks. Racks, yo, big racks, I need my cake like a fat bitch.
Man, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy I Be Tweaking, man. I'm back with another video. As said and as promised, this time range meta. So without any further ado, not here to waste y'all time, let's get it. We gonna get into these combat builds first, specifically for non-pitfall maps. Now, I usually run the range outfit for most of my builds. If you don't have the range outfit, we'll get into what you could use for your accessories, your bottom skill, and your top skill later on. But for now, let's get into these weapons. I use the Kusanagi sword from Orochimaru. I know that there's better weapons out there, but as far as like Sasuke's ninja blade, those blades actually are really good. Sisui's katana's pretty good, but again, I don't know the combo, so I'm not gonna recommend something I don't know much about. I do know that it's pretty good though. Sanban, ninja tools, man. Always Sanban for life. Stop playing with me. If you're using the Demon Wind Shuriken, you're messing up your team's combos. You're not really putting in that damage that you need to. You can get people off bases with it. It could be useful for that. But other than that, it's always Sanban. That's how we rock it, man. Keep that Sanban on you. The accessory skill for the range type was complete ass. It was like a 15 hit buff, and you're not gonna get a 15 hit combo with a range usually, so I rerolled it for one in a million. Let's get into Kamui Lightning Blade. So basically, when you hit somebody, whether they got their guard up or not, it's gonna deal damage, just gonna lower their defense, and it's Kamui Lightning Blade, so you can actually get through certain jutsus with Kamui Lightning Blade, because all attacks are nullified when you're in Kamui Lightning Blade. If you're a good range, you can use Phoenix Flower Jutsu. It takes people subs away, but it's more of a close range Jutsu. Lightning Shuriken Net has been buffed. Also, you can use this for your first ninjutsu. But you gotta know how to hit it though. That's the only thing. You gotta know how to hit Lightning Net, or it will become completely useless. They also buff Icicles. There's a lot of things you can combo up with range. That's the beautiful thing. But they also buff Icicles, and that can cause a lot of damage when comboed up with our second ninjutsu, Majestic Destroyer Flame. Some people don't like it. Some people say it's just the regular thing most ranges use. But honestly, Majestic's OP even though they nerfed it. So I'm always rocking with Majestic. Shadow Clone Jutsu for life, man. Y'all already know I'm always using that. And Kamui Shuriken. If y'all pull up to my stream, y'all see me miss this plenty of times as I've been learning how to play range. But Kamui Shuriken is definitely one of the best alts. But range does got a lot of good alts, but not good enough. Not good enough. We're going to get into what alts you can use on certain game modes. But overall, Kamui Shuriken is the way to go. So we always going to be rocking with Kamui Shuriken. Let's get into pitfall maps and why I use Kamui Bond and why I think it's completely OP. A lot of people say it's a crutch for range. It's a useless jutsu. Don't let them lie to you, especially if you're just learning range. Kamui Bond, what it does is increase your movement speed and your attack power while you're in it and reduces your ninjutsu cooldown time. But if you also hit Majestic and Kamui Bond, it does like almost double the amount of damage. It's really OP, especially when you're close to the pit and people are putting pressure on you or you're getting jumped. Kamui Bond, they can't jump you no more, man. Get up out of there. So that's why I use that. So let's move on to base. Like I said, it's pretty much the same exact thing here again, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, the only thing that has changed is Amaterasu. Amaterasu has gotten a little bit of a buff in the past update. In the recent update, and it's completely OP now, and it's definitely worthy of being called meta. It's gonna put a lot of pressure on people at B. It's gonna put a lot of pressure on your defense, and if used correctly, can put in a lot of damage. So getting back to the clothes, if you don't have the range outfit, some of the best top skills, I think, in my opinion, for range are Power and Spades and First Blood. Your bottom skill, especially if you're just learning range or you're trying to be a little bit more tough, and have that survivability ready and resolute is really good. And it's always one in a million when it comes to your DPS, ATKs, and range. You want that one in a million when your team is on a roll. Last but not least, our flag battle build. We're going with power and spades and a flash to boost our movement speed and one in a million. Now, I cannot stress this enough to you. As a range, it is your number one job to retrieve the flag. That's why you need this jutsu right here. You need pull. You need to know how to use it. And if you don't, you're going to sell your team. It is your main role to retrieve that flag. So don't blame anybody else but yourself. And for the alt, we're using Shikigami Dance Storm. It takes away people's ninjutsu and their secret techniques. So either way you use it, if you're using it to defend your flag, or if you're using it to make that push, it's always going to be reliable and is definitely worthy of being called meta. These are your builds, y'all. I hope y'all paid attention. I hope y'all learned something. Drop that comment if y'all have any questions. Stay blessed, man, and stay up on these shitters. Peace. Don't care no price, I cop it, be in your bitch steady, jockey me. These bitches love Sosa, oh, and the no man. Fucking with them.